Motion gears here. Today I will be showing you how to rig the eyes and the eyebrows. Also, I will show you how to create facial expressions and save them for later use. Before we get started, we are glad to announce that we updated our extension, the 2D Rigging Toolbox, link in description. If you don't know, the 2D Rigging Toolbox helps you to rename your Illustrator layers and import them easily in Moho. For more information, check the video in the upper right corner. Now let's get started. First, let's see some eye expressions and get an idea how many points we need to control the eyes and where to position them. So after analyzing those shapes, I think we need a point at each corner to achieve any eye expression. So let's rotate the eyes by 45 degrees. Group the eye and the pupil. Let me rename those layers correctly. Do the same with the other eye. As you can see, the pupil is getting outside the eyes. To fix this, create a mask on the group layer. Now let's create boons to control the pupil movements. The first boon will control left and right movements. The second boon will control up and down movements. The third boon will be the eye target to control the other two boons to move the pupil in any direction. To make the eye target work, select the left and right boon, click on boon constraints, and in target choose the eye target boon. Do the same with the up and down boon. Here I'm fixing the boon's parenting because I created the boons while other boon was selected. As you can see, now we have the eye target controlling the two other boons. You can add angle constraints to limit the boon's rotation. I need to give the eye target enough room to work properly. Let's create a smart action for the left-right boon. Rotate the boon to the left at frame 1 and go to frame 100 and rotate the boon to the right. It's preferable to use linear keyframes in smart actions, and you will have full control to use easing keyframes on the smart boon itself. Instead of animating the pupil layers themselves, let's create boons and bind the pupil layers to them. Make sure to center the boon in the pupil. Remove the boon strength. Open the eye left right smart action. Select both pupil boons and move them to the left at frame 1 and to the right at frame 100. Open the eye up and down smart action. Move the pupil boon up at frame 1 and down at frame 100. That's it. Now try the eye target boon to make sure everything is working properly. You can control the pupil size by scaling the pupil boon. To scale the pupil boon, hit the control key while clicking on the boon and dragging. Let's create the upper and lower eyelids to make the character blink. First, let's duplicate the eye shape, change its color, rotate the shape 45 degrees. Open the layer settings and in masking, choose mask this layer. Scale the eyelid shape. Adjust the points to create the upper eyelid and refine the curvature. Add a stroke if you like. As you can see, I added the stroke not on frame 0, so I will cut the keyframe and paste it on the frame 0. Duplicate it and rotate it 180 degrees to create the lower eyelids. Duplicate the layers and place them in the other eye. Let's add some smart boons to control the blink, also control the upper and lower eyelids individually. Of course, make sure the controllers aren't parented with each other. Let's rename the boon to easily differentiate between them. Create angle constraints. I will start with the right upper blink. Create new smart action and go to frame 100 and rotate the boon and drag the points down. Now you get the idea. I will do the same with the other controllers. In the blink smart action, there is no need to animate the points. We can animate the eyelids boons to make the character blink. Here I already rigged the right eyebrow. Let's walk you through the process in the left eyebrow. First, create three pin boons. Create a boon from the third pin boon to the first pin boon. The reason we added the main eyebrows boons in these directions because the inner corner of the eyebrows should have a wider range of motion than the outer corner. Okay, now parent all the pin boons to the eyebrow long boon. Remove strength from the four boons. Use the point binding to bind the points to the pin boons. Let's test the rig. I'm hitting the Alt or Option key to rotate the boon. As you can see, it has a wide range of motion. Now for the most important part, creating the eye expression shapes. You can duplicate the eye layer and change its color to see it as a reference while deforming the eye shape. I added some markers to organize the blend shapes. Now start deforming the eye for each expression. You can use a reference photo to create the eye shapes. After you finish, you can use the same technique we used for the mouth rig in the previous tutorial by adding the expression to switch layer. But this time I want to show you how to use morph actions. The morph actions are used to save poses for multiple layers so you can apply them later while animating. Like saving the pose of the eyes, the pupil size, the eyebrows and any other layer inside the rig. Then you can insert it at any time in the timeline. First, let's create the poses for the eyebrows in each face expression. Now we are ready to add each pose to a morph action. Click the checkbox beside the boon layer and any keyed layer you wish to add to your morph action so you can see all the keyframes on the timeline. Let's set the keys to smooth to blend better on the timeline. Now select the boon layer and copy the keyframes of each pose and put it in an action. Make sure you key the properties on each pose even if they haven't changed from the previous pose, so when you use the poses in different order it will morph correctly. That's it for today. I hope you learned something new. If you have any question, let us know in the comments and don't forget to subscribe to get notified with our future tutorials. This is Motion Gears. Thank you.